Researchers at the Indian Institute of Technology, Delhi, have developed a new method to detect positive cases of COVID-19. According to researchers, this new method is a probe-free process and promises to drastically bring down the cost of coronavirus testing. The IIT team claims that the new method of test significantly reduces the costs, making it affordable for a large number of people. Researchers feel that at this time of crisis, it calls for a development of indigenous test kits. Using comparative sequence analysis, unique regions of COVID-19 have been identified. Now, these unique regions are not present in those not infected by COVID-19. Now, the National Institute of Virology in Pune is in the process of validating this process on clinical samples. Till yesterday, India had tested a total of 16,911 samples, out of which 315 were found positive. Latest confirmed cases in India now stand at 341. We are now joined on the phone line by Prashant Pradhan, who is a researcher from the team developing this non-probe testing method from IIT Delhi. Prashant, thank you so much for talking to WION. First of all, for the benefit of our viewers, explain how this test identified positive COVID-19 cases and how it promises to dramatically bring down testing costs.
So thank you. So it's a one-step RT-PCR method where we are detecting the specific unique regions of COVID-19 only. So there are other types of coronaviruses also. So through our bioinformatic analysis, we have found the unique regions which belong to this only COVID-19 family. And by taking help of these unique regions, we will be able to detect this virus.
Right. So how is this test different from the tests that are already in use, and why is this so much more cheaper than the ones that are currently available?
So as far as we know that currently the probe-based methods are there and the probes add to the cost. So our assay is probeless assay, which basically helps to reduce the cost.
Right. So the government has now asked all private labs also who have been approved to conduct COVID-19 tests that the cost shouldn't go up more than 4,500 rupees so that it is available to the general public at large. How much do you expect this test to cost for the normal people?
Right now, in terms of exact amount, I will not be able to comment on it. But yeah, it will be significantly cheaper than what right now the costs are.
Right. So we are learning that the National Institute of Virology in Pune is testing it on clinical samples. Any update on that?
Exactly. So we are in touch with NIV Pune. We have sent our kit for testing at NIV Pune. Once we get the green signal from them, I guess we are good to go for testing with the government institutions. Yeah.
So, see, India has a great challenge as far as COVID-19 is concerned, simply because of the scale of population. India is the second most populous country in the world with a lot more than 1 billion people. So far, there has been 341 confirmed cases. So, a readily available test kit is essential if India has to battle the COVID-19, isn't it?
Exactly. So, for one thing that we know is that if we can screen mass, if we can go for mass screening, it will be really, very helpful to contain this. So in this way, having a cheaper diagnostic will help to go for mass screening.
Absolutely. Mass screening is essential if India has to contain the spread of the COVID-19. Now, tell us this test that you guys have developed in IIT Delhi. Once it's a non-probe method that we are learning, that you are telling us. And secondly, once the test is done, how soon are the results expected?
So the whole process will take around 3 to 4 hours. And after that, it will be you are good to tell the results.
So once a patient is tested in 3 to 4 hours, we would know, or the patient would know, whether they are positive or not, so they can isolate themselves and seek treatment. So the results will come soon. So that's a big advantage of this test, isn't it?
Yeah, So basically, what you added first is that for the preliminary test, for the first test, the government, the cost was 1500. So I'm talking about the first step of that test. So that result will come to into 3 to 4 hours, and then it might go for the other two tests.
Right. So this is a screening test for, it will indicate whether a person is positive or not, and then further testing will be done, treatment will be given. Now, to explain to us, how many members are in your team, Prashant, how much time and thought and effort went behind in making this test?
Basically, we are 9-member team, and if I start with, it's like Pal Gupta, Ashutosh Pandey, Akhilesh Mishra, Praveen Tripathi, and our PIs, Dr. Manoj Balakrishnan Menon, Vivekanandan Perumal, and Vishwajit Kundu, and Professor James Holmes. And it took us almost 25 days to reach to this, because there were a lot of other things to get, so that we can just confirm that our kit was working well or not. So, and we worked day and night. So yeah, so we got it.
Certainly, and if this is passed and by the National Institute of Virology, then this will be a great boon for all of Indians who are at risk of contracting COVID-19. One final question, how often or how soon are you hoping that your new test process will be available to the general public? And does anything like this exist in any other country in the world currently?
I guess as soon as we get nod from the NIV Pune, we'll be good to go. And right now, to my information, basically probe-based methods are there. So So what I can say is that our probe-based method can increase the rate of mass screening, and which will also lower down the cost.
Right, Prashant, thank you so much for joining us. IIT Delhi team has developed this new method that promises to drastically bring down the cost of coronavirus testing, making it readily available for Indians at large. Remember, India has so far, till yesterday, screened about 17,000 people. 17,000 samples were tested, out of which 341 today, the figure stands at 341 confirmed cases. Large-scale testing is important in India if India has to fight the spread of the coronavirus.